This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to explain how to find the area of a regular polygon. So a regular polygon is a polygon where all of the sides have the same length. In other words, they're all congruent. And all of the angles have the same measure. So they're also congruent. And what I want to do is derive a general formula that will tell me what the area of any regular polygon is. So here's how we're going to do it. I'm going to use a pentagon for this problem. We could use any regular polygon. We could use a hexagon or an octagon or whatever. I'm going to mark the center, and then I'm going to draw a line from the center to each of the five vertices of the pentagon. Now what that's going to do is going to be to create five congruent triangles. Each triangle will have the same area. If I knew the area of one of the triangles, I could figure out the area for the whole pentagon by multiplying it by five. Now I have a formula for the area of a triangle. The formula I usually use is that the area of a triangle is 1/2 times the base times the height. When we talk about polygons, we're going to have to change some of this terminology. So the area for the polygon, starting out with the triangle part, is going to be 1/2 times, instead of saying base, when we have a polygon, we talk about the length of a side. So instead of a B for base, I'll have an S for side. We also don't use the word height. What we do is we talk about the distance from the center directly to the side. Now that distance is going to be actually be a perpendicular line drawn to the side. And that distance is called an apothem. So the apothem is a line that's perpendicular to one of the sides and goes from the side to the center. So we're going to say the area for one triangle is going to be 1/2 times the side times the apothem. But I'm going to have to multiply that by the number of triangles I have. So the area for the polygon is going to be 1/2 times the side times the apothem times the number of sides, or 1/2 SAN. Now, more often, you're going to see the letters rearranged, and so you'll see people saying the area is 1/2 times A, and then maybe in parentheses, times S times N. And most often, what you're going to see is this, that the area is 1/2 times A, and instead of SN, you're going to see P. P stands for perimeter. If I want to know the perimeter of a polygon, I'll multiply the length of one of the sides, S, times the number of sides, which would be N. So I'll multiply S times N, and that will give me the perimeter. So the standard formula that you're going to see for the area of a regular polygon is going to be the area is 1/2 times A times P. Okay, let's plug some actual numbers into this pentagon and see if we can find an area. So let's say that the side is 3 centimeters. So S equals 3 centimeters. And we'll say that the apothem is about 2.1 centimeters. So all we have to do is start with the general formula, area equals 1/2 AP, and then just plug these numbers in. So that's going to be 1/2 times the apothem, which is 2.1, times the perimeter. So I want to take that 3 and multiply it by the number of sides, which is 5. 3 times 5 is 15. And now if I multiply all this out, I'm going to find that it equals 15.75 square centimeters. Don't forget, if you've been given the units, you've got to put the units in and the fact that they are now square units. Okay? So I just want to do one more, this time with a hexagon. And what I want to do here is show you that sometimes the apothem will be given with a radical sign in it, like the square root of 2 or the square root of 3 or something like that. So let's take this hexagon. I'll take the general formula that I have. The area equals 1/2 AP. I've been given the fact that the apothem is 5 times the square root of 3 inches. And I've got a side length of 10, which means since it's a hexagon, there are 6 sides. I'll multiply 10 times 6 and get 60. So I've got 1/2 times 5 times the square root of 3 times 60. I'll multiply 1/2 times 60 first and get 30. That'll be 30 times 5 times the square root of 3. I can multiply 30 times 50 and get 150. So that's going to be 150 times the square root of 3. I'm dealing with inches, so that's going to be square inches. And of course, if I wanted to, I could put this 150 times the square root of 3 into a calculator, and that would give me a decimal number that would equal the area. Okay? So I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.